Welcome back. This is KTN Prime. So is President Uhuru Kenyatta more agitated than usual in his speeches these days, or is he just being more open about the stresses of his office? If he is indeed under too much pressure, should Wanjiru, that is the ordinary citizen, be allowed to see and listen to the president in such stressful moments? This is the focus of tonight's episode of Spotlight 2017 with KTN News senior political reporter Duncan Khaemba.
Both in times of plenty and of want.
When he took over the presidency, he painted a picture of a cool, calm and collected chief executive. Nearly every public appearance was a statement on its own, with many crediting President Uhuru Kenyatta as a humble leader who had demystified the once dreaded office of the presidency. Fun and light moments were part of his signature. But 48 months later, is something amiss with the president's temperament?
That is his thinking. You know, you must understand a man and his thinking. Backwardness. Backwardness. Pettiness. 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 You know? Yeah? Pettiness. Yeah? Germany. Yeah? Kwa sababu hataki kuona mbele, hataki, hawezi ashindane na wale ambao wanaangalia mbele. Hawezi ashindane na wale ambao wataka maendeleo. Hawezi ashindane na wale ambao wanataka umoja. He thrives in division and in poverty.
3 weeks ago, it was a similar occurrence when State House hosted a governance and accountability summit where the president gave a dressing down to holders of independent constitutional offices, accusing them of frustrating the war against corruption. In fact, he even went after the Auditor General for entertaining the idea of pursuing the Eurobond investigations in the United States.
When we go out there and we say Eurobond money was stolen and is stashed in the Federal Reserve Bank of New York, are you telling me that the Treasury and the Federal Reserve Bank of the United States have colluded? Yani mjinga ni nani? Surely. That the Kenyan government and the US government have colluded. Na huyu anasema anaenda nataka kwenda ku interrogate Federal Reserve Bank of New York. Guy, anyway. You know, you sit back and you ask yourself, are we being serious with what we are doing?
In September, during the burial of former cabinet minister, the late William Timama, the president uncharacteristically tore into a church leader who, in his address, had asked the government to prioritize national cohesion to stop further polarization of the country. And just like others, he was dealt with on the spot by the seemingly enraged president.
Kuna Bishop mwingine hapa. Sijui ni nani, lakini nataka tujuane, ambaye amesema umoja mbele ya maendeleo. Mimi nataka nikuambie Bishop, kwa sababu wewe unataka uongoze roho, lakini kuongoza roho lazima pia uongoze maisha ya watu. Umoja ni kitu muhimu, muhimu sana. Na mimi naungana na wale wote ambao wanasema tuwe na umoja ya Wamasai, tuwe na umoja ya Wakenya, naungana na hawa sana. Lakini kusema umoja bila maendeleo, hiyo ni ujinga ya mwisho.
Some analysts believe the president's seeming impatience with perceived detractors began earlier in his administration. On October 9, 2014, immediately after returning from the Hague-based International Criminal Court, where he had been summoned to appear, the president castigated civil society, whose leaders he termed as unpatriotic Kenyans.
and we will not join the ranks of you ambao mnaenda kulamba matako ya wengine kule. Ndio upatiwe pesa. Na kazi yako nikonda kutukana nchi yako, kutukana serikali yako.
A section of opposition leaders see this as a sign of an overwhelmed presidency.
Nafikiri jikoni imekuwa moto sana. Walikuwa nalia sana juu ya baba yangu Raila. Sema amefanya namna hii, amefanya namna ile. Hawa nataka kujulisha hawa ya kwamba kazi ya kukosoa serikali ni kazi ya Raila. Hana kazi nyingine.
According to communication expert and political analyst Barack Muluka, the tirade the president is engaging in doesn't augur well for the office he holds.
When you ask for the office of president, you are not asking to be sent on a picnic. You are asking to be given the opportunity to shoulder the nation's burdens, and you must demonstrate the capacity to shoulder them with calmness, with equanimity.
According to Article 131, Section 1E of the Constitution, the president is identified as a symbol of unity and as such, mandated to act in such a manner that promotes national unity.
But some of the pronouncements that the president makes tend to make some people feel alienated.
Deputy President William Ruto also seems to have taken a cue from his boss. On Sunday, standing right in the middle of the church, he tore into former devolution CS Anne Waiguru.
Mama anafanya hapa kwa saloon. Aende ya register kampuni 20. Siku moja. Aende apatiwe kandarasi. Alipwe million, karibu inafika billion. Yeye mwenyewe anasema, mimi nilikuwa napeba pesa hii mamilioni kwa gunia kama viazi. Really? Halafu mnatuambia, mnatembea hapo kuongea Kiingereza mingi, ati unajua, sasa imekuwa, imeenda, ikarudi. Hiyo ni maneno gani hiyo? Wacheni upuzi bana. Tuambie ni ukweli.
Some experts now say the outburst may be in direct contravention of the constitutional provisions on leadership and integrity under Article 73, Section 1A, Subsection 2 and 3, which states authority assigned to a state officer is a public trust to be exercised in a manner that demonstrates respect for the people and brings honor to the nation and dignity to the office they hold.
They tend to diminish the stature of the office of the president, of the presidency in the public eye, like when there's a spat between the deputy president and a disgraced former cabinet secretary. There's something totally amiss, and their handlers perhaps need to talk to them again and advise them that they need to exercise their public appearances with more composure, more decorum.
Watch a media waseme vile wanataka kusema. They would be bothered about small things, my friend.
After all, when all is said and done, remember this.
Yale ambayo tunasoma ni ya upuzi. Kwa hivyo vile nilisema ya kwamba gazeti ni ya kufunga nyama ni sawa. Tuendelee namna hiyo.
Duncan Hemba, KTN.